G'day guys, I'm going to be checking out the mod Valkyrie. I haven't actually seen it yet, so this is essentially the sequel to the Awarded More mod I created, and it's made by Judska with the help of a lot of community members. Shout out to Shutter, to Dessa, Kill, and also the model makers. I think Normand had a lot of new models added to this mod. So it's a competitive base mod, and it's containing a lot more balance, same amount of factions, new maps, additional sounds, and obviously the great polish Judska provides for it, as his high quality videos do show. He's added better polish, better icons, and etc. Streamlined the game a bit more to make it look more professional. So let's check it out. I haven't actually seen this, haven't played Minable really since November last year. So it'd be good to have a look at what's changed. I'll just go through briefly the core changes in this mod. So the core ones are the anti-tank guns receive half veterancy, faster reload time, better accuracy. The autocannons 20mm 40mm do increase damage but to default now, but a bit less than the World War mod, which is default prior. Damage drop-off, 0mm of penetration at the maximum range of all cannons, which stops the fast shooting exploits of tanks, so TDs will be more effective, but does not for the HE exploits, but we've got the anti-tank gun buff to help out with that. Cool thing also, player score equals the total amount of MP killed, so you won't have some strange combat number. You can actually tell how much each player killed and how much each player lost in terms of MP. More maps added, as you can see a few maps here by Shotter, and the same old classics, R6 single maps. VT, who's this? There's a whole bunch of VT maps which I don't know. So many 1v1 maps, jeez. That's good. Also sounds by Shotter, he's added a whole new sounds for all the tanks, and nothing, it's all unique, not from GSM or anything, it's all new, which apparently does sound more beefy and nice. And new units and models and that. So let's check out some of the, I want to check out the actual units so we can see how the competitive game will be played. I'm going to check out USA first. So the summary I got from Judska of all the nations. So USA super semi-automatic rifles give the Americans a distinct advantage in long-range shootouts, as the M1 Garands and shit. Elite Easy 8 Sherman Fury is the ace up the Yankee sleeve to give the nation a medium tank terror to supplement their excellent infantry power. The changes to tank destroyers also allows Americans to utilize Hellcats, Sluggers, Wolverines, and to a greater extent than Vanilla. True, I'd like to see those Hellcat rushes. So let's check it out. Fairly all the same, pretty much all the same. Oh, one thing, tier 3 infantry do have increased stamina and also speed. So it's usually skipped in the competitive mods or the default because it's not as useful as the tiers around it for price. One cool thing about this mod is the additional infantry selections you can have. So you get the veteran rifleman, each nation does have him. Single rifle at the start, 24 MP for the USA one for the carbine. So you can buy a few singles at the start, maybe mixed up with the assault squads. As you can see, you can get probably two with an assault squad almost. Then you have also the elite CQB infantry, is essentially elite assault infantry. So the Ranger class, SMGs, default SMGs, Thompsons for USA. So they're rather cheap at 115 MP. You can get three of these and maybe even two of these in the opening. Could be interesting. Excuse me. So all this is pretty much the same in terms of the unit roster. I can see everything here. Sherman's M3 Lee is still there. Nothing changed there, but you can see special points. He's taken away three because Judska thought it was too many choices and a lot of them aren't useful. So he prefers to have 12 all useful ones. So we got Marauders, which was actually in the World War mod in the last few patches. I think they have Shotgunners as well, some strange weapon. What's that? Oh, AT Rifle, boys, I didn't know that. This is new. M50 Raising and also a Shotgunner, so a mix of pretty interesting troops. I think the tier 3. Then you've got the, how much is this? Two special points, so I guess Marine, difference to Marine, what's this? Is it 50 cals or what is this? Darts aimed funny. One shots, pretty much. So it's like a 20mm. It's not really 50 cal, is it? It's not a 50 cal. It's 37mm, but it says 2x 50 cal. That's for you to have 50 cal, not 2. Nope. Okay, good enough. That's pretty good for 2SB. Definitely a good option for infantry killing. I probably prefer that to the US Marines. Veteran Sherman at 5SB. Okay, that's the Fury at 5SB. Got the Fury? Yeah, it is. Good old Fury. M1, so 6SP you get the Long Tom. Okay. So it must be have a this must be a big explosion, a big shell for 6SP. Okay, interesting options. Not too much change for USA. Let's check out the other nations. So we've got United Kingdom next. So what they are there, they're early, excellent early special infantry buyers have traditionally allowed the UK to access their medium and late medium tank classes very early in the game. New additions have given the nation a fresh option though. The Centurion has a new realistic model. Whilst it has weaker hull armor, it also has 20mm coaxial, which is unparalleled for tanks and has been priced at a more accessible range. Okay. So yeah, I like the commanders USA, probably as UK, I'll probably go that steel with the Dalal. Assault squad infantry is 100 MP, balanced as default, so I'll probably spam that still. Let's check out the veteran rifleman. Nasty. Dalal action there. 29 MP, expensive for a single infantry, but that is devastating. So I probably actually can go that and two of these. And if it's like a long-range shootout map, I could support it with that to make it a bit better in shootouts. I might do that in my opening, but... let's see, elite CQBs to get the Stens. Notice the assault squad leader gets the Thompson with the 50 clip. Let's check out further down. All the same here. All the same. MK1 Crusader at 245. Okay, just the Daimler choice. And Valentine's taken away. No Valentine either. Oh, Valentine's over here. Okay, sorry. More light options. What's this one? It's like a Crusader with a 2-pounder. Okay. So another tank, a bit better armor than Daimler. Less maneuverability though, with a 2-pounder. Okay. Tetriarch. I don't know why I would go Tetriarch, to be honest, still. Why would I go Tetriarch? Penetration's a bit better. Question on that one. I never liked the Tetriarch, and it's still 290. Why is it 290 MP? Maybe it's different. It's a Little John. It's changed its name. Is it better? I can't tell. Huh. So let's have a look at the other tanks. MK Crusader. This is the same thing, isn't it? MK1 Crusader. MK2 Crusader. Oh, okay. The armor is 40, 42. Okay. Up the ante. So they got a lot of tank options in all sorts of MP ranges at the start. So you can quickly buy a tank whenever you need to counter 20 mils. Then further up, you've got the Challenger in there that used to be in the Brit Coms in the World at War. 950. Okay. Bit up from the... get 10, not 10 extra, but... 13 extra on the armor and the body. Turret's the same. Side's a bit better as well on the body. Turret, no. Penetration wise, it's a 110 extra range. It's a much, I don't know, I'd like to go the Challenger more often, to be honest. It's just got a big turret, which is a big target. Okay, let's have a look at the specials. Royal Grenadiers, nice icon there, Judska. If it's, look at that, that looks very, very similar to the original one, so did good work there. Nice skins as well, as you can see. What the hell? Like they're like they're in the desert or something. They've got these little, I don't know what they are, to be honest. But these are just guys with EM grenade launchers, I'm guessing. Yep, two of them. And you got the Crusader. Oh, 2SP Crusader MKISES. What's this? SPG, light SPG tank. Okay, 2SP, that's good buy. Definitely a different option to go. There are no Anzacs in 2SP. Must be taken out to put in the Anzac nation. Good. That's pretty much all that's changed. Black Prince is still there. AVR is 5SP instead of 6, I believe. All the options there. My good old Cromwell SPG is now 4SP, which was 5 in the World at War mod. So I'm definitely going to be spamming that shit. Let's look at Soviets. Apparently, lots of balance changes to the Allies, I think. And Soviets have been affected quite a bit because they were considered OP in the last tournament. And I'm guessing it's been nerfed quite a bit to be saw Judska and Shotter defeat a lot of people with just spamming the Soviet charges and everything. So, veteran riflemen, they have the, yep, that's the, I can't remember, the SVT, that's right, SVT 40s, and the CQBs have the PPSH 43s. What's the squad leader have? Oh, they're all the same. Oh, no, they've got Pipishes. Huh, okay. That's pretty much it. Demolition infantry is still there. I think they got rid of recon infantry. We did get rid of recon infantry. Why? I guess no big deal, to be honest. It was an interesting change. I actually like that change. Why did you get rid of recon infantry, Judska? Let's check a look. Some of these prices probably obviously changed. 130 here. T60, 270. T70, 270. T70 is quite useless. Let's have a look at the tank choices here. BT7, 210. So got an early choice here. Can this counter, I guess, 20 mils? That's actually susceptible to 20 mils, too. That's light, I guess. T476L11. T476F34, so I guess that's the normal T-4s. The 57 has been taken out of the list, it seems. So no 57, so there's a bit of a gap in there. And also the KV-1 might be bought more because of that. So maybe see KV-1s in competitive games now. 85 has been priced lower. IS-122 at 130 MPV. Huh, what the hell is this? It looks like an IS-1 armor with a better gun, isn't it? Yeah, a heaps better, not heaps better gun. Wow, 150 range to 130, okay. Why would I get an IS-1 then if I could get this? Question mark. Just go, why? It just seems like so much better for 150 MP. Why would I get that? The hell is this? It comes with logs, floating logs on the side, which provide extra armor. Courtesy of Stalin technology. Boom. So nothing else for the chat. Oh, Moscow Guards. So T-38 at, sorry, don't rush through that. It's all the same. Tractor's still there. T-38 for 3S, 1SP. What's this? It's just MG, okay. Just MG vehicles. Not sure about that. Probably won't go that often at all. It's fast, though. Then you've got the Moscow Guards, which difference. That's replaced the 85s, the, what do you call it? Not the charge unit. The assault infantry with the T-85s, I can't remember what that was called. Let's have a look. Okay. I think it's just, I haven't added the infantry on the side, but essentially the same thing, but with 57s. 6XP, I'm not sure about that buy at this stage. Maybe it's changed in a future patch because that doesn't seem right. So that's the Soviets. Let's check out, excuse me guys, it's raining. Might add to the atmosphere of the of this video, but it's annoying, just shut it out. I'll try to get rid of it as well in the processing. Let's take a look. So we got here France. So let's have a look. France, veteran rifleman, got the MLE, decent speed, and we got the SIGI. We have, they've got the MAS 38 and all. Lafty V15, so I've added a few light vehicles there for France. Got the Hushka still there. I wonder if it's one shot still. 13M, ooh, it's pretty weak actually. It's like 50 cal kind of thing. And then you've got Vickers. Quite a few AT guns. Vickers AA, that's a pretty good one. This, we've got all this in the World at War, so nothing's changed. Renault 70 MP. Good old Renault. F-17. Ooh, okay, got the Chardy one. The Samo, wow, that's cheap for a Samo. 4756 turret. I like that at that price. That's really cheap. Shitty gun, but I like this. I like it. A Renault B1. 60 armor. 47mm gun. Renault B1 Bizter. Is this the one with the... No, it's not. It's the one with the extra armor. So I'm not sure if you left the revolver in there. That was a fun one. Look at the armor on that beast. This is the new one. ARL-44. Post-war tank, I think. I don't know. Wow, look at that. 120, 110, 150 range, 129. Can take out a Tiger at max range. Okay. It's a This is a beast, eh? Oof. Okay, that's going to be, I guess, for big games. Uranium tank destroyer, 47 mil. Renault Biz 1, 75 millimeter anti-char. Okay, so the new one. This is a anti-tank gun, which is actually, sorry, an anti-tank destroyer, which has a good armor, 48 to 82 in the front, with a 75 millimeter gun at 680. It's quite expensive, but it's quite impenetrable for a price. It's pretty good. Similar like to a Stug, but I think better armor than the Stug. And a bit cheaper than the Stug. Okay, Magellan line defense, is it the same thing? Yeah, probably the two guys with the... Yep, French tower defense, mortars. Okay, one mortar. I think it's a bit bigger. No, it's a small mortar. Vive la France. A bit different, so more... It's like British troops with... British stealth commandos, so it's a change. Instead of being a mass kind of charge resistant unit, the Wojja Grenadiers, Grenadierów. It seems like these are maybe from the colonial guys. Oh no, they're Polish. Oh, okay, oops, mind my reading. It looked like an African word. Okay, Polish guards, they've got a lot, and they're third tier. We're not 37 mil. Let's have a look at this baby. This is like a... This is not very... Oh, okay, it's like a 40mm type autocannon, which kills infantry and stuff, so... Not bad. Demi Brigade. Oh, okay. This is the British... no, this is not the British. This is the French... French Demi Brigade. Poussins Filioux. This is a... This is the 3 Special Point Artillery. That's still in there. That's a favourite in the World War. Char Biz on revolver, changed to a SP unit it seems. This is the Char Biz with the revolver type cannon, which reloads really fast. And after this, I think 5 or 6 shots, it takes a long time to reload. The auto cartridge, AMX, this is a new AMX 1375. Huh. Got 5 SP. I don't know the stats on this, but it's fast. Looks like a big cannon. That's 75 mil. What is this? What shells does it shoot? 75 mil, yep. Okay, interesting at 5 SP. Grand Battery, is that just like a Royal Artillery? Yep, pretty much. 2 heavy artillery pieces, and the 8 SP AMX 50/100 is... Wow, giant. That's at 8 SP. So 100mm gun, 90 armor front, I'm guessing. Okay, so a few new tanks here. It's a tank, the French look more versatile now, so... Forgot to read. So national bonus, Vive la Resistance, unique among allied nations in their diversity in late game options and their traditional style. They utilize slow but potent mortars and snipers in the early game to let them grind and frustrate their opponents. They subsequently can wheel out some extremely impressive late game tanks. That's a big change from my mod. They were never a late game tank player. They weren't good at tanks. Interesting. Okay, so China. Let's check look at China. That might be a long video, actually. China. Maybe I'll do allies first and do access in another video. I think that's what I'll do. So, allies. So, China. What they lack in quality, they make up more in their quantity. Vast reserves of cheap CP infantry options allow China to simply overwhelm their opponents. While they may lack in regular tank options, they can rely upon the special point buys of the impressive A-19 anti-tank gun for tank busting, and even the T-34-1. So... Looks like, oh, nice icons. Looks like they have tank options now, which may be okay. To be honest, I like the variety, the balance where it's not that, I guess not every nation has a heavy tank and not every nation has overall abilities. Because it makes the balance a bit, I guess, plain Jane. CQB infantry, got the MP18s. The helmets haven't, the helmets are interesting. What the hell? Okay, it's a missing entity in the mod. Judska, if you see that, you can fix it. CPU, what's this? So I've got the ZPU-4, what's this? Is it 20 mil? Oh, nice, look at that. Oh, nice, okay. So we got that. PAK-35, with a nice little classic wheels. 150mm, Stulskoski monster mortar. This is like the Chinese 150mm type sorry, the Type 92 Japanese mortar variety. Very cheap. Then you've got in the tank range, you've got the BA6, this is new. Is this just machine guns? Nope, it's a 45mm, 20k gun. Not bad. BT5, AMR, same thing, 30mm, 22-2, Stuart, Chaffee, all they're the same. Sherman, so nice to look at this, my The World at War skins. Nice one, Recon. Just like that unique Sherman eyes on the side. Okay, then you've got Hoi. Oh, he's changed it. Used to be the Muslim warriors or Muslim soldiers number 2. They're now 1 special points. Just because I lowered them there. 300 MP though, wow. 300 HP for 1 special point unit, wow. But they've got just stens. Still pretty damn good, to be honest. They'll be spamming that shit. Still the same one, which is that charge of the Panzer I. Willy's AT at 1 special points. Interesting. Okay, a few rushing options here for China. It'll be a lot of cheesy AT infantry charges with this vehicle, I believe. Shutter. Guerrilla Uprising. Okay, same thing. Then you got the Korean Rebels, still the same stealthy units, like Brandenburger type with SMGs instead. SU-12, new one. This is the... okay, howitzer. So howitzer type vehicle for 2 special points. Might struggle. Think of this one though. It sounds like it's got a big gun, but it's not very good for withstanding counter HEs, like for BA, you're fighting Panzerans and stuff, that'd be a problem. Burma Old Soldiers, they're probably, I'm not sure if they got stealth, they probably would have stealth, but these are probably US troops. What type of guns do they have? Recoilless rifles, maybe? What's this? ZBV-26, that's a French gun, isn't it? Recoilless rifles, okay. Then they've got the 122mm at 3SP. Oh, 3SP for an arty. Okay, interesting. Similar to what the French have, I guess, for their artillery 3 special point option. Then China Uprising, still the same thing. Ooh, nice. I like this one. Still the same CP. 100 CP, what? No, really? So pretty much you got to lose your entire forces to buy this? Maybe not, Judska. Have a look. Foreign aid, 56 MP, the Chaffees, yep. And this is the late... Okay, don't have too many late tank options. This is good. It stays in the spirit of China, but they have the WZ 122, 120mm, 230 armor somewhere. Must be in the front, but that must be 10? That's 9. Wow. That must be a beast. Okay, so I think, let's check what, is that all the allied nations? No, Anzacs, so we've got Anzacs here, let's have a look, is there a description thing for the Anzacs? No, so there's no description for the Anzacs, let's have a look. So this replaces the British Commonwealth in the World at War, so I'm guessing he took out some of the Canadian stuff and that made it all Anzac. Diggers for third tier, okay, what do they have? Got the Stens, they just look like Anzacs. SASR, oh cool, look at that. Yeah, nice little desert masks on. Veteran Rifleman, they've got the trench gun. Trench Enfield, yep. Then CQB Infantry, Sten, okay. That must be quite cheap, yep. Assault Squad Infantry, it's pretty cheap too, but the, okay, they've got the Owen gun at the squad leader level. Universal Carrier, what's that one? Okay, it's just just that bugger. Options here, same as UK in terms of their anti-tank capabilities. The mixture of tanks here, you got the Renault as option, as an option, you got the Fiat, what's this? Kangaroo! And then we've got Fiat as well, M13, it'll be up and then another Kangaroo. So I guess these are all captured Italian tanks, which have been stamped on with the Kangaroo icon. Staghound, okay, it's been put onto here. I think it was, sorry, it was in actually in the British Commonwealth before. Stuart, interesting type of Stuart. Then you've got Chevy LDGR 180, okay, 20mm, okay, so this is a charge 20mm gun. LDG, light range, long range desert patrol. Cool, M3 Grants in here. Firefly, so not many heavy tank options. Firefly is the heaviest right there. So it keeps in the spirit of Britcoms. Light vehicles, light attacks. M3 half-track. Okay, so that's a 6-pounder half-track. See, boys, 80 carrier. Interesting. Spare one special point. Okay. Volunteer rifles. Okay. This is a squad, I guess. Jungle gun. Huh. One special point. Oh, cool. This is like a shotgun. It's not actually working like one. It's not locking people over. Interesting. So like some sort of organ gun. Desert rats. Same old, I guess, with just additional HP. 250 only. 40 mil buffers. Okay, interesting. Staghound. What's the difference between that one and this one? Ah, it's the 37 mil. Okay, sorry. There's two staghounds now. That's the original one now. It's a special. 4.21 inch mortar. Carrier. Okay, that's 3 SP. Quite expensive. Oh no, it's actually got a big mortar now. Okay, bigger mortar at 3 SP. Interesting. Radio operator. Same. Staghound tulip. Ooh, wow. Okay, that's pretty hardcore. That's better than the... Oh, it might not be better, to be honest. It's just faster than the other... Than the Sherman tulip. In the... what do you call the Sherman tulip? You call it tulip. 6 and TD. 5... Oh, okay. We've got a big TD option, which is... what is this? This looks like a TD. That looks like a... what shell is that? 188. Okay. I wonder if that can kill tanks. It's called TD. It can shoot straight. Can it shoot over things? Yeah, it shoots in the arc as well. Veteran Firefly at 6 SP. Ooh, nice. I like this. But spawning with four guys only, 80%. Let's go. Churchill. Same as this, 75%. Needs one more guy in this one. So this is like a 7 SP better... Yeah, 7 SP Cromwell tank, 4 SP. Wow, that's a bit much. I guess it's just invulnerable kind of thing. It's instead of the Cromwell, but for its purpose, I suppose, where it's meant to be killing emplacements and shit over the hills. I wouldn't buy this pretty much often at all. I guess if you're facing off like head on a BS3 on this map, you'll be confident to charge it. Pack 48. Alright, I think I'll just go... Yeah, so that's the Allies. I think I'll go through the German... the Axis stuff later. It's just too long, so... I'll see you around, guys. Just in time for the tournament, I'm going to just do all this, and... Hopefully, the tournament can get cracking.